I welcome you all with Islamic greeting, Assalamu alaikum. Which means, may peace be upon you. This is XLFC. Microsoft Excel Fan Club. What was in the last video? 1. How some or summation function works. 2. How use some function to get result for different ranges. 3. How and when to use mouse and keyboard to select cell references. 4. How some or summation function behaves with string and error values. 5. How to make error value, dividing by 0, and correct the error, etc. Link of previous video. You can follow the link on your screen to see what was in last video at youtube.com. Today we will be learning about the average function, which is the second most widely used function in Excel. Among you, those who did not see my previous video about sum function, I strongly recommend you to see my previous video following the link shown in your screen. Or, form the video description, at youtube.com. The reason I am asking you to see the video, is, I will be skipping the core concepts those I have discussed in my last video. The reason of this, those who have watched the last video, they will get bored. Let's talk about today's topic, which is average function. In step 1, we are going to average our data by selecting the data separately, as we wish to have the result at D6 cell. Let's select the cell first, as all Excel formula starts with equal. Let's put an equal sign in the cell first then, followed by type an average and use an opening parenthesis to start selecting the data source. Since we are going to select our data separately, so it is convenient to use the mouse to do so. Using your mouse, select the B4 cell. I hope you guys remember, in my last video, I said that as long as the blinking line appears in the cell border, that means that cell is not fixed yet. Use a comma sign to fix up the cell and make Excel ready to pick up the next cell or next data source. Using your mouse, select the C4 cell. Then use another comma to fix up this cell. Following the same method, select the rest of the cells. Since all of our data has been selected, use the closing parenthesis and hit the Enter key on your keyboard to get the average of your data. Step 2, here we are going to average a range of cell values. To get the result in cell D12 first, type an equal then type average, use an opening parenthesis then using the mouse. Click on the D10 cell, don't release the mouse yet, now drag the mouse till cell no F10. As all of our data has been selected using and closing parenthesis, we have to close the average function and hit enter to get the result. Step 3, here we are going to use the same method just like the step 1. I am discussing this step, only to make you know that you can average the data from different sources. It is not mandatory of having the data side by side. You can average the data by this method from different sheet of your Excel file, even from another file or Excel workbook. To get the result in the cell K6, type equals and write average, followed by an opening parenthesis. Now select the data sources using your mouse. First select the I4 cell, use a comma then select K4 cell. Using another comma, select M4. Now use a closing parenthesis to finish up the average function. Hit enter on the keyboard to get the desired result. Step 4, here we are going to average the data from different ranges. Again, this is not mandatory for the data to be side by side like me. You can choose the data from separate sheet, even from separate Excel file. We will learn about them in our later lessons in detail. Now let's learn the basic. To get the result in the cell K14, type equal first, then write average, and use an opening parenthesis to start selection the data source. Using your mouse, select from cell I10 to cell J10, as you can see the blinking line, that means our data source is not fixed. Use a comma to fix the range and to select the next range, select cells from L10 to M10. Use another comma to make Excel ready to pick up next range for you. Select the cell form I12 to cell M12 as the final range in this case. Use a closing parenthesis to close the function. Hit enter to get the result in the K14 cell. As you all have seen in my previous video at YouTube, how some function reacts, or, behaves with string and errors. The average function does the same thing like the sum function. So, I am going to skip this part. If you wish, you can visit my video at the link shown on your screen. I hope all of you have understood the whole concept well. If you still have confusion, please feel free to comment them out in the comment section. What we have learned in this video: 1. How to use average function of Excel. 2. How many different methods you can apply to get the average of your data. 3. How to select single range and multiple ranges for the same function. 4. How to fix up the range and how to make Excel ready to pick up the next range. 5. How errors and strings are handled by average function. Keyboard shortcuts used in the video: no keyboard shortcuts has been used in this video. That's all for today. If you like this video and this video comes to any help of yours, don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel, ExcelFC. Stay connected to get more videos on Microsoft Excel. You may like to visit my blog at excelfc.blogspot.com, or excelfc.wordpress.com.